Drawing a cube is probably one of the first things you're going to do when writing a 3D game engine. It seems to me that this is the hello world of 3D real-time rendering, so I'm going to show you my take on that. I'm going to go through all the files and show you how I set up my build, how I did the math for the camera, and how I wrote the shader. So this is the entry point of the application. The winMain function does some initialization first, then handles the game loop and releases allocated resources in the end. First, I create the window and OpenGL context. I save the aspect ratio when the window gets resized to calculate the projection matrix of the camera later in the renderer. So after creating the window, I bind the OpenGL functions I need for rendering the cube. After that, I enable phase culling since I don't want to draw the inside of the cube, and I enable depth testing so that the faces appear in the right order. Theoretically, that is not necessary with a cube where the inside isn't drawn because there are no overlapping faces that way, but because that is such an extreme edge case, I do it here anyway. Next, we can look at the renderer. Here, I create and store the handles for the vertex and index buffer. I store the vertices and indices I use for the vertex and index buffer in a separate file. The vertices contain the position in the first three floats and the normals in the second three floats. The indices then define which vertices are used for which side of the cube. Apart from the positions and normals in the vertices, I also pass a few projection matrix to the shader with a uniform buffer. I create the shaders with this function call, which itself calls a function to load the source code of the shaders from disk. The vertex shader just passes the normals to the fragment shader and uses the view projection matrix to adjust the position of the vertex. In the fragment shader, I use the normals and a constant light direction to create some diffuse lighting. The view and projection matrix are calculated here before the draw call. I multiply them together before every draw call once, so not every vertex has to do this individually. I create a look at matrix by defining an origin and a position to look at, which here is just the center of the cube. The projection matrix gives a sense of depth since vertices further away appear smaller. The lookat function computes the front, right, and up vector and uses those to create the matrix. The projection matrix takes a field of view, the aspect ratio from the window, and a near and far clipping plane. And in the vector 3 file is the math to create the right and up vector. The getRight function takes a front vector and the getUp function then takes a front and a right vector. And the math file just calls the corresponding math functions. The only things left are the build and run scripts. First, I set up the environment for x64. This only needs to be called once in a new console. To build the project, I create a build folder and call the compiler from there. I compile everything in one compilation unit and use the start.cpp file as a source file, since that one includes all the other files. And the run script just executes the program. So when I call the setup script, it tells me that it set up the environment, the build script executes the compiler, and when I execute the run script, we get the result I showed in the beginning. If you have any questions or feedback, let me know in the comments, and thank you for watching.